All right, so we are also going to be installing several other really cool pieces of LCI technology. Right here, you have their Flow 636 Enduratech device. This right here is designed to help winterize your RV very quickly. Basically, it's a water drain down system. It kind of blows out all your water lines so you don't have to worry about any freezing water, you know, forming in the line and breaking it. And the key behind a product like this is that it makes the process much quicker and simpler. And you know, when you look at some of the really awkward temperature changes we've had in South Texas and even other parts of the country, something like this, which traditionally would not be something you need down here in South Texas, is something you sometimes have to consider, because winterizing a unit down here is so rare that when it happens, you may not be doing it right. So having a product that can help simplify the process, speed it up, and make sure that you're doing it right can be really important. So this is one piece of technology that we'll be putting in. Second, we'll be installing this really cool Solera shade. Let me flip it over so you guys can read it in English. So this is the Solera front shade, and this is super cool. It's a very windy day today, so we're gonna have to be careful how we put this on. But it's essentially a real big screen panel that ties into the front of your awning. This is only supposed to take a couple of minutes to install. So what's gonna happen is that we'll extend the awning out, and there's a channel at the very end of it. And this is simply gonna slide into that channel to give us this really nice shade that extends down. Now, you do have to be very careful. You can't just go out and buy this assuming that it's universally gonna fit your specific shade. You have to know the length of your shade. You also have to know how high off the ground it is once it's fully extended. And the specific one we're using here, I believe, is designed for 10 foot worth of clearance between the ground and the bottom of the actual, or the edge of the shade whenever this is fully deployed. If you get the wrong one, it's not gonna fit, or it's gonna essentially be elevated above the ground with this large space, because again, it's not designed for the distance between the edge of the awning and the ground. So we made sure to take measurements on this that it would be the right one for this specific awning. So you definitely wanna consult with whoever you're buying this from to make sure you've taken the appropriate measurements so you don't get a product that you end up having to return. And then finally, we have the tire link system. So this is LCI's tire pressure monitoring system. Now you might ask, what about the truck's TPMS monitoring system? Well, the F450 actually does not come with a tire pressure monitoring system from Ford. There's no way to even get it added as a factory item. And what I'm looking forward to is really the setup process, because my tire minder system, it's a good system, but it's all modular, which means I have space on my dash that has to be set aside for the actual monitor itself, whereas this is all gonna work through my smartphone. Yeah, and typically in the past, I didn't want that. I didn't want my smartphone handling everything, but now I'm kind of in this world where I'm tired of having so many things sit on my dash, and it will be kind of a relief to be able to remove some of those to be able to, you know, work it through this system. That's gonna be really cool. But yeah, that's all the stuff that we're putting on. We still have the LCI technician back there. He is hard at work finishing off the bumper. He's gonna be doing the suspension next, and I'm filming that in another video, so look for that video. I don't know which one's gonna post first, so it's gonna be really confusing from a timeline perspective. So the whole LCI crew essentially came out this week to try to knock all of this out in 1 week. So I'm bouncing around all over the place. They're currently working on the one control system inside. A lot of wires, a lot of stuff that they're figuring out. It's a very windy day.
It is.
So real quick, how do you compare today to yesterday?
I think today feels great. Coming from Northern Indiana, this is more our speed. You know, it's cool. It is a little breezy, which makes working a little bit more difficult, but sweating yesterday was not our ideal situation.
Yeah, you guys came out here going, man, it feels so good, it's warm. And then like 30 minutes into it, they're all down to their t-shirts man, this is insane.
We're trying to get rid of clothes.
Yeah, humidity, that's what it is. We don't have dry heat here, it's crazy. Yeah. Anyways, we'll let them get back to it. We'll be putting this stuff on. Hopefully the wind dies down a little bit and we'll be able to put this screen on the awning here. It shouldn't take very long. Even if we just have to demonstrate it and take it back off, I think we'll be okay.
It's a quick install.
Very good, and you know what? LCI actually makes the awning as well, so if the wind tears it off, I have a place to get a new one.
Yeah, we'll get it figured out.
Yeah, we'll get it figured out. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is open up my One Control app. I'll put in my secret spy pin code, and I'm gonna go to my awning, and I'm gonna push the awning out. So, Tanya, Ryan feels capable of installing the awning. Is that something he should do?
Sure.
You just slide the polycord
through the
channel. Okay. There we go.
You see right here, it's got the polycord. And on our, at least on our Lipper awnings, the Solera awnings, there should be an extra channel for this.
Perfect. So I was going to do it from my app. Thank you for ruining that experience for me. We're good. There we go. I'm using the app to extend my awning. It's coming out. I do have a ladder.
Or you guys can do like the...
Let's see what we got here. And we are close. Whew! That is close.
3/4 inch is spared.
And
there's where it goes in.
Other than the sticker that you're going to have to remove it through.
Very cool.
That screws up. I can't do it.
Check that out.
I can't do it.
Now talk about...
I can't do stickers.
I can't even reach
the Well, let's talk about one control. The fact is that if I didn't have this, I'd be eyeballing it out this window to see how close I am. I am 3 inches shy of hitting the wall here. And it's getting windy again, so we probably should get this kicked off. All right, let's get a ladder.
All right, so I'm going to do this as straight as I can for you.
So this channel...
Yep. You can see the sticker that's kind of like a foot in. You'll take that out. Whole thing off as best you can, that'll help the adhesive not slow this down when you slide it in there.
All right, polycord's going in.
There we go.
I think I should go around the front of the ladder.
Yeah,
I
would.
So generation two, or I don't know what generation this is, maybe generation five, would be cool if you could roll it up with the awning when you're done. Can you roll this up at the awning?
You just take the bottom half off so it's not as heavy.
The zippered portion.
Well, cool. Okay, continue. Yeah.
Yes, you
Good job.
I mean, it's your coach, so if that looks good to you,
I'm happy. Let's do it.
Yep. So, you're saying like right here? Yeah,
like,
stick it to the Velcro. I usually stick it to the Velcro first, so that way it's like lined up. And
that totally makes sense.
Okay, so now I have a question. So,
what's up, sir?
You ran it through. Wasn't too difficult. It's definitely what I would consider to be either a two-man quick job or a one-person slightly slower, right? Because you're going to need to kind of reposition it a couple times. I do like the fact that you can unzip the lower portion and the top portion kind of rolls up with it. Really nice. Turning into a bit of a kite right now. The Velcro, which some people might wonder, that's to keep it from sliding anymore. So the Velcro basically holds it in place. It's Velcro, so you can pull it off and remove this portion if you want to, which is nice. And then there are some ground stakes to hold the bottom of this in place. And I would imagine it probably even helps the awning a bit if it gets really windy. It keeps it from wanting to bounce up and down too much, I'm guessing. But still, anytime it's real windy, pull your awning in. And he operates a zipper very well.
Thank you.
We only brought people with zippers.
We found your niche.
Yeah. This was a qualification for coming out today.
There you go. And then this will
very cool.
This will roll up. With
and this can kind of flap if you need it to, so that's nothing I think real bad. But the good thing is it's of a height that's manageable. So if you're going to put this back in place, you can. Total install time from unboxing, because that's where you have to start, right? Somebody gets the package and they got to open it, to exploring what's in the package, to reorienting it and getting it in place. 10 minutes. 10-15 minutes max.
You want to retract it? You can see how it rolls up.
Yeah, let's retract it with my One Control app.
I was going to say, I wonder if you're going to remember on your phone there.
Of course I do.
I stole his thunder a second ago.
All right, awning.
Oh, you went right on the inside.
He's like, what are you doing?
I am going to retract the awning. And it's going to roll up. Okay, I see it creasing over here. Is that a bad thing or is that completely fine? Yeah, I don't think it would really matter because it's more of like a screen. It is super windy outside. Best time to be demonstrating how awning and awning accessories work. Let me come around to this side. There we go. Check that out. All right, so that is very cool. So we are going to move on from this project and move to the tire pressure monitoring system project that I think is already pretty much complete, right?
Yeah.
We just need to. Yeah, we need to pair it to the One Control app. And this is the nifty little to-go bag that you get with the Solera Shade awning portion that you don't use, and then the ground stakes are in that little bag. Very cool.
Ready to go.
Ready to go.